Welcome back, Hot Wheel Collectors and Diecast Enthusiasts. This is part two, our second video of my Redline collection, and this is the music from my friend Rudy Harley, and the album's Just Guitar on Mog Records. And that's what we'll be playing in the background in this whole Redline collection videos. And here is the record label if you're interested in getting this record. Here's the back. It's all acoustic instrumentals. And he is on Instagram as 164th underscore Avenue. And he's got quite a collection. Does a lot of customs and really neat dioramas. So 164th underscore Avenue on Instagram. Give him a follow. And all right, we're ready to go. So from 1974, the Buzz Off. And here's the Redline version. I'm not gonna go into prices and stuff like that. WTF4 YouTube is very good at that with the prices and values, so give him a check if you haven't already. And here's the other variations. These have the plastic base, where the first one had the metal base. There's a very rare version of this blue one that has this tampo on it. And with that, we'll take a look at these black walls from the Gold One series. And we'll flip the hood open. You take a look at that. The plastic bodies were from 1976. These gold ones are from 1977. And up next, 1971, the bifocal. Really nice die cast. Features this clear hood that opens. And from 1970, we have the Caribou. Got another sample to look at. Here we go. That is this one with has the gold wing open doors. And we got a special here for you. There we have a pink Caribou from 1970. This one in mint condition is valued at $250. Doesn't appear to come out pink, but trust me, it's a nice hot pink. And Pretty cool. All right. Up next, I'm gonna check out some one of the first heavyweights in my Red Lion collection, the cement mixer. You can't tell, I'm going in somewhat of an alphabetical order. Here is the light green version. And up next is the purple. And I'm not sure, maybe somebody might know if that's one of these is a reproduction cement mixer. One doesn't have any logos on it. The other one does. Not sure if that's a sticker. It looks like a sticker, so maybe the sticker just didn't get put on that one. So there's two variations of the cement mixer, and both these are from 1970, and that is a sample of my first two heavyweights. Up next, 1969 Chaparral 2G. And this one doesn't seem to be quite that popular, but I like it. And here are two versions for you to look at. Number 3 and number 9. Okay. And up next, we have a couple of Spectraflame Red. With the whiter spoiler, that's a reissue, and the one with the lighter white is the original. So there are spare parts that you can get. I think I got those from Bright Vision. You'll have to find these without the spoilers because they come off so easily. And also, has an opening bonnet. And the last of the Chaparrals is this nice Spectraflame Aqua. And from 1975, you have the Chief Special, and I do not have a great sample of this, but I do have two samples here for you to look at, and this is the old 442 die cast, which is very rare to find. Here are two samples of the Fire Chief Special from 1975. And we're going to set one of these aside for a second because we have a variation 1976. There's a more interior version of what the car should look like, featuring the red bar as opposed to the blue siren. Next, 1976, the Chevy Monza featuring a plastic base, and I believe this was probably part of the Super Chrome. There is a rare version, very expensive, from the Mattel Manager Christmas Party Ball. And that can run right around $2,750 if you find that. Okay. And back to 1969, got a pair of Classic 31 Ford Woodies. I would say one's probably a magenta, that one right there, and then this one here, maybe a red rose. Very rare brown version. It is estimated at $3,000. Condition, of course. All right. Oops. It went a little backwards. That's okay. Up here. Got the 1974 breakaway bucket, and this car here, and clearly not in great condition, was only raced like that. There is no other color variation or any other base variation, and I think it's probably pretty rare to find. And that is from 1974, the breakaway bucket. And from 1968, one of the Sweet 16, Beatnik Bandit. Side by side. Actually, this is the first red line I've gotten in my adult life. Paul from Toy Peddler sent this to me as a gift, and I haven't looked back. And now I have 500 plus red lines and growing. So thank you, Paul Brittle from the Toy Peddler, and I'm not sure if he still owns it. I've heard rumor that he may have sold it, so Toy Peddler is a great place to pick up red lines and such. Diecast. Here's a sample of the gold version. is a broken windshielded aqua version. It's too bad because the diecast itself is pretty good condition. And same as goes with this orange one here. Next, from 1970 club kit cars, there's three, and here's one, the Boss Hoss, and I think the other one was a Heavy Chevy, and maybe the Cuda, I'm not sure, but I do have them, so they will be featured in one of these videos as I go through them. Up next, 1969 Brabham Repco F1, Formula One. This one's missing the exhaust pipes. Racing decals on that one. There's a aqua. There's a green one. Let's put those two side by side and do a little color comparison. So the one with the number one decal is the aqua, and the one with the Hot Wheel is the green. Pretty close in colors. Purple version, also missing the from 1971 Bug Eye. A green version. Let's see if we can show these with the heads open. is this for part two. And I'll try to squeeze some more cars in number three. So thanks for watching, and we'll be back.